The burial ceremony commenced with Mass led by Monsignor John Vianney Sunday, the vicar for Kabale Diocese.
When we have some moments to be here, or we experience conditions like this, there are four reasons why we come together here, especially when one of our dear ones dies. And the Catholic Church has four reasons why we converge to give a sacrifice of Mass or ecclesiastical funeral to our dear ones. There are four reasons. One, to pray for the dead.
While delivering her eulogy, Nyegameha's widow disclosed that the couple's plans to celebrate their 45 years of marriage with a grand anniversary were all shattered by the news of her husband's death. The children of the deceased pledged to uphold their father's legacy of generosity, ensuring that those around them continue to benefit from their endeavors.
You know, my father was a man that did not have an example. My father is a man who has left us with a great example, shoes that are too big for us to fill, but he himself did not have an example. And I was genuinely deeply grateful for a man that persevered through so much to give us everything that we have today.
The business community, leaders and friends have lauded the deceased for his reliability. They have acknowledged Aponye's significant contribution to Uganda's economic development.
You and me know very well that quite often we used to have problems of market for our produce, especially maize. But when Aponye and his colleagues in the Grain Council organized themselves, they have now turned grain and maize in particular to be a significant cash crop in Uganda and also a significant commodity for export to the neighboring countries.
During the ceremony, Thomas Tayewa, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, rallied Ugandans to emulate Aponye's work ethics if they aspire to achieve similar success. The Vice President, Jessica Alupo, who represented President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni as the chief mourner, expressed concern over the increasing road carnage. Alupo further conveyed Museveni's appreciation for Aponye's significant contributions to both the National Resistance Movement Party and the economy, leaving behind a lasting legacy.
The country has continued registering increased incidences of accidents on our roads, especially those that are caused by trucks that are parked after breaking down. And His Excellency the President asked me to share with you, Monsignor, together with all the members of the congregation, that he is concerned that that act may not be sufficient enough to stop the road carnage in our country. And therefore, His Excellency the President has directed as follows. The Attorney General, Honorable Kiryowa Kiwanuka, will on Monday present the cabinet to cabinet proposed guidelines to improve the implementation of Section 58 of the Road Act 2019.
President Museveni offered a condolence contribution of 10 million shillings to the bereaved family. President Museveni offered a condolence contribution of 10 million shillings to the bereaved family. Businessman Aponye tragically lost his life in a motor accident last Thursday in Itojo Town Council, Ntungamo District.
The late Apollo Nyegamehe was a big supporter of the NRM and an active actor in the economy. He will be remembered for his business acumen and entrepreneurial spirit, which enabled him to create wealth and jobs for many people. I urge especially the Bazukulu to emulate his example of exploiting the prevailing favorable conditions of peace, stability, good infrastructure, etc., to create wealth and jobs. May his soul rest in eternal peace.
Apollo Nyegamehe, commonly known as Aponye, was born on August 12, 1957 in Muhanga, Rutshiga District, to the late Peter Turicharuche and Salome Chibatenga. Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.